Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 93 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 160 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 161 and question 162. Question 161. You need to move the blueprint files to Azure. What should you do? To understand it better, let's go to learn.microsoft.com and understand what data transfer methods are available. We are in learn.microsoft.com on transfer data to and from Azure page. We'll scroll down. First option we do have here is physical transfer. Using physical hardware to transfer data to Azure is a good option when your network is slow and unreliable. Getting more network bandwidth is the cost prohibitive, and the security organizational policies don't allow outbound connections when dealing with the sensitive data. This is the scenario when physical transfer is recommended. There are two main options for physical transporting data to Azure. However, we do not have large amount of data, therefore these are not recommended. First option is Azure Import Export Service. Second option is Azure Data Box. Next is command line tools and APIs. In our answers, we do not have any command line tool or APIs option, therefore we will skip this one. However, we could have used AZ copy. Next option is graphical interface. In graphical interface, we do have two options available. The first one is Azure Storage Explorer, which is available in answer as well in the question. So this would be the good option for us to transfer the blueprint files. The second one is Azure Portal, that is not available in answer. Therefore, we can select the Azure Storage Explorer. Let's move back to question. Option D. Generate shared access signature, map a drive, and then copy the files by using File Explorer. This method is used in file share, and that is not recommended to store the blueprint files. Therefore, it is not the correct answer. Option C. Use the Azure Import Export Service. Azure Import Export Service is used for large amount of data. That is not preferred in this case. Option A. Generate an access key, map a drive, and then copy the files using File Explorer. It is similar to the option D, but access key will not allow us to access the file share, and file share is anyway not recommended to store the blueprint files. Therefore, we are left with option B. And option B is use Azure Storage Explorer to copy the files would be the best option available to transfer the blueprint files to Azure. Question 162. You plan to deploy several Azure virtual machines that will run Windows Server 2019 in virtual machine scale set by using an Azure Resource Manager template. You need to ensure that NGINX is available on all the virtual machines after they are deployed. So we need to perform a post deployment task, and we need to identify what are the ways we can conduct this post deployment tasks. Let's go to learn.microsoft.com to understand it better. We are in Azure documentation site, and on introduction to Azure desired state configuration extension handler page. We'll scroll down. The primary use for Azure desired state configuration extension for Windows PowerShell is to bootstrap a virtual machine to Azure automation state configuration service. This service provides benefit that includes ongoing management of virtual machine configuration and integration with other operational tools. Therefore, this could be one of the options in or question where we can conduct post-deployment task on virtual machines. Let's see another option. Next option available for post-deployment task on virtual machine is custom script extension for Windows. We'll scroll down. The custom script extension downloads and runs scripts on Azure virtual machines. Use this extension for post-deployment configuration, software installation, or any other configuration or management task. So this could be the second option. Let's go back to question. Option A, the Publish-AzVMDscConfiguration commandlet uploads the desired state configuration to Azure Blob Storage, but it doesn't ensure that virtual machine will have NGINX installed after it is deployed. Therefore, this is the wrong answer. Option B, Azure Application Insight. Azure Application Insight is an extension of Azure Monitor and provides application performance monitoring, and it has nothing to do with the deployment or post-deployment task. Therefore, this is not the correct answer. Option D, Azure Active Directory Application Proxy, or now the Active Directory is renamed to Entra, so Azure Entra Application Proxy. It provides secure remote access to on-premise web application, and it has nothing to do with the deployment. Therefore, this question is available over the internet with the two different options. You may find this question over the internet with one correct answer, which is the desired state configuration extension or DSC extension. The another version of this question with the correct answer is the Azure custom script extension, option E. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.